Welcome everyone to the Federal Cloud in the Field. Thanks again for your audience. If you are not subscribed to this channel, make sure to go to the AKA link below and click subscribe and hit the bell to receive notifications when new episodes are uploaded. And today we are going to talk about a new integration that we have in the Federal Cloud, and no one better than the developer behind this integration, our friend that's been on this show previously, Bar Brownshtein. Bar, thank you very much for being on.
Thank you, Yuri. Thank you for hosting me.
Absolutely, my friend. So let's start giving an introduction so folks can understand what really is cloud infrastructure entitlement management.
Okay, great. So SIEM, it's a cloud infrastructure entitlement management, and security organizations use SIEM solutions to manage identities and access privileges in cloud environments. SIEM solutions helping organizations defend against data breaches, malicious attacks, and other risks posed by excessive cloud permissions. And the goal is to have a look on all of the users, all of the entities and applications in your cloud environments, and understand who they are, what they can do, which permissions they have, and where they can access, and manage all of this.
Okay.
And nowadays, a SIEM solution is an integral part of cloud security vision, and because we need to protect users, but we also need to protect from users. And by the way, when I'm saying user, I mean any identity. It could be even application or virtual machine or even serverless function.
Just for the clarity, the SIEM in this case is not with S.
Correct.
We also hear SIEM, which is our Sentinel solution, but in this case is the Cloud Infrastructure Entitlement Management with C.
Correct.
So what are these Entra permissions management and what are we doing behind the scenes?
So Entra permissions management are the evolution from Cloud Knox to Microsoft product under AED. They provide visibility and control over permissions and groups and creates the PCI, the permissions creep index score. This score reflects the security risk or how much user is risky. The PCI is higher, there is more potential to damage and risk. And customers always aim to lower the PCI to reduce the risk exposure.
Why did we choose to connect Entra with Defender for Cloud?
So first of all, we wanted to have a first connection of SIEM project to MDC as a first step, part of a lot more that will come in the future. And that will allow the resource owner or the InfoSec team to see the risky users they have in their organization and everything as part of their security posture inside MDC.
Okay.
And besides, they are giving cross-cloud full visibility for all of the environments, Azure subscriptions, AWS accounts, and GCP projects. And as I said, everything in one place in MDC. And that way, organization will be able to discover these risky environments and move to the Entra portal at the moment for remediation or to see what are the recommended actions to take.
Nice. And looks like you have a demo to show to us how that works, right?
Correct. Correct. So here's the MDC portal. I will start with the security posture blade. And here you can see the whole security posture of the organization by subscription, account, or project. You can see the secure score. You can also see the number of unhealthy resources out of the total resources. And if you want to see the recommendations, you can click this button to see only the recommendations of the particular environment. You can also see an aggregated overall a summary for your organization, and you can see the total number of resources, and you can also filter by environment. And as part of the integration with the Entra permissions management, we have added a new tile. And the tile presenting the number of unhealthy environments out of the total connected environments. To see your environments, you need first to connect it using Entra portal. And from here, if you want, you can click to navigate to Entra portal for further recommendations and actions. This is the first part of the integration. The second part is from the recommendations bled. And here, we can search for the recommendations, start with PCI. And here, you can see three new recommendations. You can see the number of connected environments out of the total environments. And for example, I have one out of two unhealthy accounts, which connected to Entra. And if I want to see the exact PCI, I can click on the recommendation itself. For example, let's look on projects. And here I can see the PCI status. For example, for this project, the PCI is 88, and a PCI under 32 makes the environment as healthy, because as I mentioned, higher PCI, it's a higher risk. And at the moment, if I want to take further actions, I need to move to the Entra portal. I can also see my healthy environments, and I can also click on the project itself to see more recommendations on this particular project.
All right, great. So the when you go back to the security score dashboard real quick, so the first visualization that customers they face is that tile that was added, right? So that tile is just to bring visibility. Is the integration already done behind the scenes, or there is any configuration that needs to be done?
Correct. If you don't have any environment connected, let me choose another subscription, for example. When navigating to the security posture, I will see the following tile. For example, you don't have any connected environment, so please click here to connect your first environment.
Okay, and then when you click there, there is I'm assuming there is a wizard or some sort of guide through to make this connection happen, right?
Correct, using Entra Portal, correct.
Okay, so that will basically redirect to Entra Portal.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, excellent. All right, Bar, so what's next on this integration?
As I said before, we wanted to have a first integration with same project. So we started by presenting this PCI score for any subscription, project, and AWS account. But this is only the first step. Entra Permissions Management has a lot of capabilities, and we are working to bring them all into MDC. We are creating, for example, to present data in lower levels, such as a specific user or group, and also in resource pivot. As well as giving the ability to remediate risky permissions directly from MDC without navigating to external portal, because we want the customer to have everything in one place. I guess that's all. I recommend all of the customers to connect their environments and try it out, and we would love to hear any feedback.
Awesome. And if you are watching this episode and you have any feedback on this capability, make sure to write your comment below, or go to our user voice and add suggestions there as well. With that, wrapping up this episode today, Bar, thanks again very much for your time.
Thank you, Yuri.
All right, everyone. Thanks for your audience. Again, make sure to subscribe to the AKA link below, and see you again next time.